Hi, my name's Ray, and welcome to part one of our three-part project, Things You Can Make with Household Ingredients. This is a great starter project to see how well you can mix ingredients. Today we're going to be making Oobleck, and Oobleck is one of those interesting things that is similar to quicksand, where it's not a complete solid, but also not a complete liquid. The things you'll need for today's project include a towel for cleaning and a spatula for mixing, a large mixing bowl, assorted food coloring, 2 cups of cornstarch, 1 cup of warm water. First, mix 2 cups of cornstarch. Next, we're going to add the food coloring to the water. This will make cleanup a lot more easier. A few drops of blue. A little bit of red to make an interesting purple. Next, you're gonna take your water and food color mixture and slowly add it into the cornstarch. You might not even use all of the water. Slowly add it into the cornstarch, and once it solidifies, you know your Oobleck is ready. Pour a little bit, mix, a little bit more, and as you do this, you can see that the Oobleck is starting to form. Keep mixing until it starts to form, and once your Oobleck starts to mix, feel free to get a little bit dirty and start using your hands. This will allow you to actually get a better feel of what the Oobleck should start to feel like, and it will actually make things a lot more easier to mix. Now that you have all of your ingredients mixed together, you should have a really interesting consistency of your Oobleck. It's not a complete solid, and it's not a complete liquid. Try to see how it reacts when you add pressure to it and when you don't add pressure to it. When try picking it up, see if you could even pick it up and what happens when it just sits in your hands versus you trying to squeeze it. I hope you enjoyed playing around with Oobleck and see what interesting observations you can make with this. Check out our next week's video, part 2 of what you can make with household ingredients. Bye! I'm trying to pick up a huge blob. Are we still wrong?